In this video, I am going to explain anatomical relationship from liver to other structures. From previous video, I explained liver dysfunction oftentimes affect right shoulder tightness and right neck tightness. Okay, liver to right shoulder and right neck. But if you understand today's connection, you can understand more complicated internal organ connection to muscle and joint connection. Okay, it's very, very important. First structure I'm gonna talk about is diaphragm. Okay, liver and diaphragm are connected by connective tissue. It's part of peritoneum. Peritoneum is membrane of organs. What kind of membrane, what kind of connective tissue is that? I'm gonna explain three tissues. First one is this blue one. This is on right side and it looks like triangle shape. It is right triangular ligament. Right triangular ligament. This is very strong connective tissue. Okay. Next one is this membrane connects liver and diaphragm very, very broadly. You see that? This is coronary ligament. Coronary ligament. Because its shape is like crown. Okay, that's why it's coronary ligament. Last one is connective tissue on left side. This part, this is on left side. We had right triangular ligament. This should be left triangular ligament. Left triangular ligament. Okay, these are connective tissues that connect diaphragm and liver. If these tissues get tight, maybe that can affect breathing, correct? Because they are connected literally. Does it make sense? Okay, let's move on to relationship between liver and stomach. Okay, they are connected by this tissue. You know, this blue one is deep to liver. Thus, you don't see this structure in this picture. Okay, what is this blue structure? This is lesser omentum. Lesser omentum. This one connects liver and stomach, and partially that connects to duodenum. So stomach and duodenum. So when stomach gut dysfunction, these symptoms oftentimes shows up at left shoulder or left cervical spine. Okay. Liver, right shoulder. Stomach, left shoulder. But if you see they are connected by lesser omentum, you can suggest maybe left shoulder tightness can be from liver because of lesser omentum. Or sometimes maybe right shoulder tightness can be from stomach because of via lesser omentum. You see that this relationship? I explained the stomach connection and liver connection. But if you combine these information, now you can suggest more complicated connection. This is very, very important thing. I explained connection with diaphragm and stomach. Now let's move on to next organs. Next organ is large intestine. Remember, liver is on right side. Thus, liver has relationship with right side large intestine, particularly around flexure. Flexure means the curvature of large intestine. So they are connected by connective tissue. Large intestine. It's connected by hepatocholic ligament. Basically, large intestine dysfunction can affect lumbar spines, core muscles, pelvis, and hip joint, particularly around core and lower extremity. But there is connection between liver and large intestine. If liver gets dysfunction, this can affect core and lower extremity because of this connection. I think this is kind of minor connection. It's not big, strong connection. So this is kind of rare. Liver usually doesn't affect lower extremity. However, every single connection counts, right? Thus, this is important thing. Large intestine, hepatocholic ligament. Next one is kidney. Again, liver is on right side. Thus, right kidney has strong relationship with liver, right? And kidney and liver are connected by hepatorenal ligament. Hepatorenal ligament. By the way, this is kidney. These two guys are connected by hepatorenal ligament. Kidney is freaking important organ for low back pain, tight low back, and pelvic movement. Then, again, liver has connection with kidney. Thus, liver dysfunction can affect kidney. That can affect lumbar spines and other core muscles. Basically, large intestine and kidney are important for core and pelvis. Liver has connection with large intestine and kidney. Thus, liver could affect core tightness, core pain. Very important organ. Now, at last, I would like to explain relationship with the core, okay, core muscles. This picture is showing only internal organs, right? But in reality, there is muscles, there are skin, there are the fat tissue, right? There should be muscles around here, okay? Next, tissue is connected to anterior wall of core muscles. Anterior core. What kind of connective tissue is that? That's this. Please visualize in three dimensional. This blue line connects liver and anterior wall of the core. Okay? This is falciform ligament. Falciform ligament. Okay? This one connects liver and anterior wall of core. Thus, when liver gets tight, that can affect core muscles. That's very common. Okay. Anyway, from liver dysfunction, that can affect diaphragm, breathing, stomach, left shoulder, large intestine and kidney, core muscles, anterior wall of core, the whole part of core. Thus, you need to understand connection of organs. Now you can understand the more complicated, more advanced connection. This is freaking important thing to know. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.